I'll try to show you that too, some still shots of that. And I want pancakes. Because
what better thing to do than sit around in your robe and eat pancakes
well,
on a snow day
anything.
And eat, period.
So, Sven, I've only had a quest bar today and coffee and maybe a bite of pizza. Or two. Two bites. Three bites. Could you do me a favor? I've got a little sous chef here. Can you have me
sure.
a bowl from down here? You have to get down there and get it.
Okay. You know, nope. He has to talk to me like I'm a child when it comes to kitchen.
Anything.
Which?
Now we're going to make Bisquick pancakes. This is just plain Jane, honey. And I would try to go healthy, but it's like it's a snow day, so
which kind of?
We just need plain yumminess. That green one's fine.
This is cute.
Thanks. Sure, Ramey got that for me. Rinse that out. Folks, this is real life. You have to rinse out your stuff.
I don't even know.
A little water next time. Okay. I've got my pan here. Actually, can you get my bacon strips out of the freezer?
I sure can.
My veggie bacon, we talked about those before. Careful. It's right there on the top. Right.
I see
down
it.
Down below.
I've got it.
No. Okay. Classic pancakes. You're ready for this. You're going to need 2 cups of Bisquick, which really, Bisquick, FYI, is nothing but
flour.
Flour, cornstarch, and leavening agents, baking soda and baking powder, canola oil, salt, sugar, and monoglycerides. So it's basically just chemical flour. Okay.
Monoglycerides. So, now this is the recipe
this is straight
off the back of the Bisquick box.
Yes.
So
and
it's
I'm probably
basically...
Gonna do, we're going to do 2 videos. Making of the pancakes, like making the band.
They have melt in your mouth
yeah,
version.
I'm doing
are we doing
well,
that one? That sounds good.
You're getting ahead of the game.
Oh, sorry. As always.
Okay. Now, I had this left over from when I made sausage balls twice during the holidays. I'm just going to take this out. I think there's a hole in the bag. Will you hold that, please?
Cheddar biscuits with Old Bay seasoning. There is a hole in the bag.
That's fine. Okay, 1, 2. We're going to start. You know what? I'm going to go ahead. Remind me. We're going to do a recipe and a half. Okay?
Oh, gosh. Okay.
Because that's basically the rest of the Bisquick. So I'm just going to do that. So
instead
of
2.5 cups.
Well, yeah, we did 2.5. So
you have to half everything. Well, add a half to everything.
Yeah. Okay, so how many eggs does it want?
It wants 2.5 eggs.
Well, yep. So AKA, we'll do
3.
Can't really do a half an egg.
Oh, boy.
These are all the eggs, y'all. And let me just tell you, first of all, you want to be my helper who throws away the shells? Don't just
yeah, I'll do that. We just cleaned this kitchen too. Mm-hmm.
The cameras are rolling, so I won't hit you.
Yeah. Ike, please, Ike.
1 egg, 2 eggs. Anyway, these are all the eggs, folks, and these are about 99 cents a dozen. Typically I would go for the organic, cage free, Florida raised, laying out in the sun with sunglasses on chickens, but these are just
take a day off but go to Disney
yeah,
chickens.
I wish. Okay. 3 eggs.
Okay.
As my friend Nancy says.
I'm gonna keep reading the recipe.
Okay, that's 3 eggs. Let me go ahead and whisk those in. With my handy dandy whisk.
These are the ultimate pancakes, with an addendum being the melt in your mouth addition. Yeah. So we haven't done baking powder yet.
No.
Right? Okay.
So anyway, the eggs are in. What else does it want? How much liquid otherwise?
2 tablespoons vegetable oil.
Okay. 2 tablespoons? Really? Over here on Classic.
No, I'm on Ultimate.
I don't know if I have all that. Yeah, I do. Okay. So it wants 2 teaspoons of baking powder, so I need 2.5. Yeah, 2.5 teaspoons of baking powder.
Actually, no, because if we're doing the melt in the mouth option.
Yeah, we're just going to do Classic and then melt in your mouth. So Classic.
Okay.
We did the 3 eggs, so we need 1 cup of milk, so really 1.5 cups of milk. And again, folks, no cow milk here. Not that I'm, you know... You can use cow milk if you want. I just don't like it.
It is better.
I just don't like it.
In IMHO.
How much did it want? 1 cup? So 1.5 cups.
1.5 cups of milk.
He says that that's 1.5 cups.
Milk. 1.5 cups.
And something to grow on.
Okay, it still is going to need 2 teaspoons baking powder, though.
Okay, hold on. Let me whisk this in here. Now you have to make... Now, pause the video right now, because I've gotten into that habit lately. I want you to tell me below, right now, get ready to comment. Everybody that watches this, it's a requirement of law, I'm going to know if you didn't do it. Comment below and let me know what your favorite snow day food and or activity is. It's a snow day for Tennessee standards, which is a little ridiculous.
Which means the sun is already out and it's going away. However, it did blow my mind because I've never seen it like this in Tennessee. Last year when I went home, it was a big storm, but it didn't snow up there. Now this year, I finally got to see, like, actually came outside and the cars were actually, like, coated.
Well, I mean, we got probably
it was a good 3 inches.
4 inches, okay.
Kid stuff.
Next.
All right, so.
The eggs and the milk, check.
Okay. Now you need 2 teaspoons baking powder.
Okay,
here we go.
Dorothy Spornak.
Okay, one moment here.
Are we doing classic melt in your mouth or supreme melt in your mouth? Let's do supreme. Do you have vanilla?
I do.
Might as well, right?
Okay.
Baby.
How much
where did our love go? My favorite. 2 teaspoons.
1 teaspoon. Two?
2 teaspoons.
Do you know what this little silver thing is on the baking pan?
To sight a sieve. What is that called? A sift?
1, 2, and then we need to do one more.
No, because if we're just doing regular plus that, that's it.
Yeah, but maybe.
Oh, yeah, okay. I guess probably a half teaspoon.
A half a teaspoon, because we kind of almost doubled the recipe. I don't really think they're going to be using the exact recipe that we are. They're mostly here for entertainment value.
We want to go with the true, tried and true.
Aldi baking powder. I think this was 49 cents, folks. Okay.
Now a tablespoon and a half of sugar. Oh, actually 2.5 tablespoons of sugar, because we're going supreme here, folks.
And we are using...
These are probably really healthy, right?
Chemical sucralose. Oh. Created in a lab.
Yeah, it's healthy. Don't you have regular white sugar? Oh, no.
I do,
no,
but
he doesn't do it. I forgot. I'm sorry.
I try to stay away from added sugar. I know this is just as bad. We're not starting a debate. It's fine.
2.5 tablespoons.
1, 2, half.
You're just like my mother. You just... I need it precisely. I can't even focus. When
Delia, this movie's for you. I feel like Delia's watching all of it.
Delia
probably
is
still watching.
Probably. Oh, and then 2 teaspoons vanilla.
Delia, honey, are you hungry? If you know what I'm saying. Why would you be? Everybody has the munchies for some pancakes.
It's true.
Okay, we did the sugar.
Yeah.
Now what? Lemon juice?
Did you do 2.5 tablespoons?
Yes.
Okay. Oh, well, no, Supreme doesn't have the lemon juice.
It's fine.
Well,
I don't want to put it in.
Okay, then it's 2.5 tablespoons. This is an odd mix of things going into these pancakes. Banda.
Bottle of lemon juice, because who has time for real lemons?
And then 2 teaspoons vanilla. I'll get your vanilla.
Oh, thank you.
I know where it is. Thanks.
You're supposed to not overmix pancakes, y'all, so I'm just getting the lumps out here.
So short, that's as far as I can go. Oh, is that it? Ladies and gentlemen, Kristen Chenoweth. Yeah, that's it.
Oh, I'm about out.
Just dump the bottle in. If she was dead, she would have dropped the bottle.
Okay, this can go in the trash. This is Aldi vanilla. Thanks. One more quick whisk of the vanilla. I'm gonna put just a dash of salt.
Salt.
And if you throw salt over your shoulder,
oh, you have
in my
do
clean
it.
Kitchen,
please
no.
Do it.
Stop it! Don't. I'm serious. Do you see this already?
Well, we'll clean that up.
We'll. It's already melting in my mouth. I know there's raw egg in there, folks, but my immune system is strong. Can handle that sort of thing.
Exercises for a living.
Okay, now we're gonna change the angle just a bit because I wanna show you the pancake batter and I want to show you the actual frying of the pancakes. We'll be back. Can't wait to see that on film.
What, you beating me?
All right, folks, we're back. I just wanted you to see the batter and the consistency. So it's just your typical yummy, delicious pancake batter. Okay, we'll see you at the stovetop. Don't mind that batter on the floor. That powder on the floor, it's his fault. And we're going. Okay. Just let's not worry about it right now. He's worried about getting that cleaned up.
Well, I want to clean it up because I don't do this. I don't do this. Any of that.
Okay.
Sometimes.
So I'm going to fry up my little pancake beauties in coconut oil. Can you go over there and check the angle for me while we're filming, please? Over there. Thank you.
Oh, God.
Yep. How are we looking? I don't really care about me. Can they see the pan?
Oh, yeah.
Okay, that's fine.
You sure you don't want to cut your head off?
That's fine.
Okay.
And I'm going to use an indiscriminate amount of, coconut oil, as Paula Deen says.
Coconut oil. Coconut oil.
Right in the pan.
We
I don't
love
know.
Paula Deen.
That's a big, hefty tablespoon.
That's a Paula Deen type of tablespoon, too.
And I would probably add more. Coconut oil at Aldi.
Explain the benefits of coconut oil. Most people don't use coconut oil. They use Pam. Or, you know.
I did explain the benefits of coconut oil in my coffee video.
Oh, true. Good point.
Which I will put at the end of this video.
People also use it to clean their teeth, don't they?
Coconut oil, they do.
Teeth pulling is what it's called? Or
well, not so much teeth pulling. That's a dentist. Oil
well,
pulling.
Oil pulling. Oil.
All pulling.
Oh.
It kind of tastes like funnel cake batter.
Oh, funnel cake.
Or elephant ears, depending on where you're from.
I love funnel cake. Fried
okay.
dough. We just call it fried dough.
While this is happening, I'm going to bake at 350. Don't want to get my robe in the batter now. Some of my... He probably won't eat any. Dogs don't know it's not bacon.
Yeah. It literally looks like a bacon strip.
Well, the main ingredients is egg white, so...
Bacon!
Oh, let me bend over here.
You sound just like the dog in that commercial now.
What the dog?
Bacon!
Get a little chemical spray here. Spritz a baking pan. I've got it on 350 because I don't like to do the bacon on a stovetop. And you don't want any of this, I'm assuming?
It's there. Can I look at the back for a second, please? I'd like to know my Weight Watchers points.
Oh, gosh.
We can go down that road.
Any Weight Watcher people here, I would love to have this debate because he claims that the slice of pizza, which is about the equivalent of 2.5 probably normal slices, is only 5 points in Weight Watcher world. Whereas one time he told me that a pack of Reese cups is 7.
That's because there's less... On the new program, Weight Watcher Smart Points, endorsed by Oprah Winfrey, I will have 2 strips, please.
Fine.
Endorsed by Oprah Winfrey, it used to work out like this. Carbs, fiber, protein.
Fiber.
Carbs, fiber, protein, and fat.
See that
fat.
Oil? It's getting hot.
Now it is calories, sugar, protein, and
okay, I'm going to zoom y'all,
fat.
So just don't get freaked out here. Can you put the bacon strips in the oven for me, please? Thank you. Thanks. Open her up.
I know what ice fishing is.
Buy strips. Okay,
three
zoom
for
here.
You, 3 for me.
Okay, I just want y'all to see, to be able to see when I put the pancakes in. And then remind me to zoom out, okay? And if you don't. Okay, I'm going to use the same cup measure.
It's very
measure
what's
pancakes.
Love got to do with it.
All right. Ooh, it's getting hot. Da 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 da. I don't know about y'all, but my glass top stovetop gets hotter than my old like coil ones that I used to.
Oh, this is I'm gonna love this sound. Here comes the sound.
Okay, let's be quiet so we can hear. Let's see if it does it. I'm just gonna do one big one every time. Let that go. Maybe a little more batter.
Here we go.
How are we looking? Can they see the bubbles? Ooh, I can.
I'm gonna zoom in. That's as far as it goes. I can see a little bit.
See those bubbles? See those bubbles, y'all? Okay, you can zoom out now. We'll zoom back in when we flip, maybe. Okay, so the bacon strips are in there. I'm gonna clean up a little. I'm not gonna knock the camera. That back. So yeah, this is a snow day, which I love. I mean, I was saying on Facebook earlier how I love that people literally are already saying that they're quote unquote having cabin fever after 3 hours of being in their house. And as you know, being in my house is one of my all-time favorite activities. I could and do stay in my house for days at a time. Look at that.
That's very true. I do get a little cabin fever sometimes.
No way.
Me?
Even here?
Sometimes.
No, not me.
Well, when you're in good company,
look,
which I'm not.
Yeah. When you know it's time to flip over, you'll see the bubbles start to form.
Yeah.
That means that they're getting done. We forgot to put cinnamon in, but we really don't need it.
No,
so
that's where the vanilla comes
let's
in.
Let's talk about syrup choices here.
Oh, boy.
Now, show them that one, will you? Or there's this. This could be yours.
Thumbs down
this
for that.
This could be yours. Don't tell them.
No, don't do that.
Video.
You're right, sir.
It's desperate for me to fail.
No, I'm not. Then this is light syrup.
Check it on the bacon because this stuff makes quick. Okay. Pretty good.
Still now, 24 grams of sugar.
Oh, y'all, it's looking pretty good.
This is sugar-free pancake syrup. I can't even imagine. I actually, to be fair, though, on my smart points, which I'm doing the best I can to not go into the negatives this week because it's a habit of mine, especially I'm not working right now, so I'm not really getting much in the way of, I have to force myself to exercise rather than do it through work. So I probably should do the sugar-free one.
Here's a little tip.
But I imagine it's not good.
Okay, can you zoom in for me? Because we're going to flip it. It's the moment. The moment has got here. They are getting very fluffy. They. One. How are we? How is it? Good. Okay, we're going to flip. So you just get it all the way on your spatula here.
Gorgeous.
I like to tuck that. Oh my gosh, this it has like
that's beautiful.
Crispiness.
That's beautiful.
The crispiness.
That's a beautifully
of a Cracker Barrel pancake.
Speaking of,
what
we're Thank going to breakfast tomorrow, right?
With Sherry Ramey,
called Pops, with his mother.
Pops is only Kingsport people would know Pops, and probably half of Kingsport people don't even know what that is. It's near Kingsport Speedway. Did you know we had a speedway?
Like a racing track.
Yep.
Why bother when you live right next to Bristol?
Well, I think, and you know, I have no idea about this. Grant Ramey, are you watching? My brother.
Zoom out.
Sure. We, I think Kingsport Speedway was first. I don't know.
Really?
Maybe. I think it was. It seems like it was. Okay, so we're just waiting on this to get brown on the bottom, and then we'll do another one. I may try to do two next time.
Oh, you're only making two pancakes out of that whole
batch? No. But
here's the thing. You take two of them, and I'll have just one like that.
We're going to spritz a pan here, and that way you can keep them in the oven as you're making them so they don't get cold. See the faces he's making off cam. So yeah, I really do want to know. Now, what is your favorite food to eat on a snow day? Just, I don't trust you to go that way because of the tripod.
Well, Tyler, my favorite food to eat on a snow day is anything that's put in front of me, to be honest with you. That's... No,
bread
I
bread and milk.
Milk, bread and milk, bread and milk. No, I guess... I like, actually, you know what? When I think about, like, in college or getting snowed in with somebody, my idea of great stuff to eat on a snow day is, like, nachos.
Ooh.
Or just Doritos. Just junk food, you know? Just bad for you stuff. That's my take on it.
Okay, now here's the deal. I'll let it cool down a little in between because, like I say, this stovetop gets so hot. Stick that one in the oven. The bacon is almost done.
How do you even know when that bacon's finished? Because it looks like just a strip of plastic.
No, it doesn't.
With a bubble in it. Tyler, what's your favorite thing to eat on a snow day? Besides the aforementioned pancakes.
I used to be big into French toast. Oh, let me tell you.
Tyler is much more in the sugar sweets.
Now, let's talk about Ginny Irvin.
Ginny Irvin. Hi, Ginny. We love you, Ginny.
We love you. Because
we love you, Ginny. Hashtag we love Ginny.
Hashtag we
hashtag
love,
blessed.
Hashtag we love Ginny. Because Ginny, bless her heart, she feels left out in these videos because we're always talking about mystery. And by always, I think it only happened twice.
Y'all, they should meet them tomorrow night. We're going to watch the Golden Globes.
We will do
we're going to go watch the Golden Globes tomorrow night at Mystery's house. Mystery lays out a wonderful spread. Ginny and Tyler are going to just, like, eat the food and talk. But Mystery and I do really try to watch some of it.
Okay, I put a little bit too much oil in here, so I'm just going to pour it back in because that is fine. And we'll get going with another pancake. You know what? I'll probably just do four big ones, okay?
Sure.
Two and two.
That means we're done eating for the rest of the day, right?
Sure. Did y'all buy that? So...
Notice neither one of us could even...
Speaking of Ginny Irvin, I was thinking about when we had that party, the Christmas party at her house, and I made cereal-crusted French toast, y'all.
Oh, I saw it.
Which means that you take cereal in a ninja or a blender and grind it into oblivion, and then you take the dipped, eggy French toast into the cereal and then make French toast. Any cereal you want. Doesn't matter.
What kind of cereal did you use?
Cinnamon Toast Crunch.
I was going to say, did you use my favorite cereal of all time? After Frosted Flakes.
Fruit Loops.
No, see, that's very... No, Cinnamon Toast Crunch.
Yeah, I feel like every kid loves Cinnamon Toast Crunch. That was always my fave.
Ask my mother, Robin Fioli, if you're watching. What's been my favorite flavor, though? Cinnamon. Always cinnamon.
Of everything?
When it comes to sweet stuff,
steak?
I could care less about... No, it's not steak, Mark.
Okay, this one is starting to bubble.
So this gets golden bubbling.
Oh, let's show you the bacon, the veggie bacon. And I say that with...
Let's show you the plastic strips.
They don't look half bad. You'll be eating them. Don't let them fool you.
Oh my goodness. Can I read what Delia Lundy said?
Delia.
This
Delia.
Is great. Delia Lundy says... She shared your page.
Oh,
I have
you.
Been binge watching Tyler and occasionally me, Tony Fioli. I don't have a YouTube channel, but I am on there a few times. Not for different things.
Okay, ready, wait. The I want you to watch the flip. Don't read it yet.
Okay.
This is a very dramatic moment again. You gotta get all the way under it and bam!
Gorgeous. I wish that, did that get captured on camera?
Probably, they can see it.
She says, the banter between the New England drama boy and the Southern gentleman about-
Who's who?
About 5 minutes into each episode is priceless. OMG, there are cats.
OMG, there are
Delia,
cats.
Delia, that's hysterical.
Where are the kids?
It's just for the fans. Don't get too attached to me, though, folks. I mean, you only got a handful more with me on it till I come back.
Rats.
Don't.
Rats.
Don't listen to him.
Uh-oh. Does anybody else? This is a weird... Fun fact about pancakes. And see if you're like this. Stephanie Myers is like this. I doubt she's gotten this far watching the videos, but...
Stephanie Myers?
Yes.
Gosh, we're going out for dinner with her too soon.
Yes.
You need to be on camera, Stephanie.
She would be a natural.
She
Do
is.
You know what I like to... You know what Steph and I like to drizzle on top of our pancakes?
Pumpkin.
No. Not syrup. Batter.
On top of it?
Pancake batter on top of the pancakes.
Really?
Yep. I know it sounds weird. Trust me, I know this. But it is so yummy.
Hot button topic on social media today is how terrible the Emma Watson Bell doll is looking.
Oh, let me see. Is there a picture of it?
Let me, hold on. We can show the people with this too. Gosh,
next up,
you
I'm
going to
make
though?
Smaller pancakes so they will cook a little bit quicker.
It is really bad. Oh.
That's not real.
I don't know if that's real. I hope not.
This is the Emma Watson.
Emma Watson, for those of you who, the three or four people who wouldn't know, is Hermione.
Hermione Granger.
That's terrible.
Even I know that.
I'm going to Google this.
I don't
see if that's real.
We're getting there, folks. It's almost going to be
panda.
So you have the option to watch the preparation and the cooking video. You have the option to watch the eating video. You have the option to just binge watch my entire channel all day long if you want to. That's really the preferred option.
People think this Beauty and the Beast doll looks like Justin Bieber in a dress.
I can see that.
Is it? Here it is. No, Tyler, that's real. Folks.
Those are real.
What do we think? I'd like to... Actually, that's something. I'm going to throw out a comment thread here. What do you guys think of this Emma Watson doll? Do you think it looks like Justin Bieber? Reply Y or N. It does kind of look like Justin Bieber. I'm very surprised somebody as famous as she would let...
Yeah, didn't she get, like, final approval on that?
Well, interestingly enough, I don't think they always do, as Carrie Fisher unfortunately found out when she said she had to pay George Lucas 10 cents every time she looked into the mirror. Always read your contracts.
Putting a little extra oil in the sink there. Not down the sink, folks. Oil never down the sink.
Oh, why is that?
Stops it up.
I didn't know that either. I think you got some oil on my eyebrow because it's on fire.
Your eyebrow is on fire?
I mean, it feels a little hot.
I don't think
I'll
so.
I'll be right back!
I don't think so. He's blind now, folks. See, now we're doing two smaller ones just to speed this process up. I kind of made too much batter, but I just wanted to
Ouch.
Use what I had. You all right?
Yeah. It's weird, though. I think you spattered on me.
I didn't splat all the way from here. It's coconut oil. It's good for you.
Maybe, is it good for the skin, coconut oil? Mm-hmm. Well, we know what Ryan Overbay's doing with his snow day. Oh, okay. Luckily, it did not show up.
YouTube is very funny. I did a bargain hunt video, y'all, and it's still coming, maybe. But there were copyright claims from the overhead music. Any YouTubers out there that can give me any advice on what I'm supposed to do about that? Because literally, the reason I did that video is because of the request. People wanted to see the inside of that store, but as soon as I tried to put it up, there were copyright claims from the artist of the songs. I'm leaking this. You probably shouldn't do that unless you're just at home. Okay, I'm gonna flip these guys.
Does that mean we can't even sing? Probably not.
Probably not. So please don't.
Well.
You don't have to worry about it with me.
Don't I though?
Although we were listening to Cher cleaning.
We sure were. Never underestimate my love for Cher.
Okay, let's see. Oh, those are staying nice and warm. I'm gonna turn that down a little bit. Oh, it's probably okay. So we'll do 4 and 2, that's 6. That'll be 2 smalls and a large. How's that sound?
For each of us?
Yeah.
Well, I'll be exercising again with my Leslie Sansone tape after that.
Now, this morning...
I'm very proud of us.
He did a Leslie Sansone DVD, and I did a Kathy Frederick tape.
I love Leslie Sansone.
Do you think millennials even know what that means if you say, like, oh, I watched that tape? They don't. Do you think they know that?
I don't really know.
Millennials
Well, that's like what she said in that movie we watched last night when she said... I'll send someone over with your tape player for your music
right.
and your video machine with your tapes. Mm. And I was thinking, wow, we watched Postcards from the Edge. 1990, I think it was. Meryl Streep, Shirley MacLaine.
And again, I don't know what it is with me, but I could watch 90 movies all day, every day, nonstop.
I think it brings us back to...
Childhood.
To childhood.
But I mean, I guess...
I love that. It was a very good movie. Meryl Streep got an Oscar nomination. Always coming back to Carrie Fisher lately, but that's just where my headspace is. May she rest in peace. It's a very thinly veiled account of Debbie Reynolds and Shirley MacLaine, Carrie Fisher's life, written by Carrie Fisher herself.
Okay.
Tyler thought it was okay.
It was alright. It was not bad. Hey, we're almost ready to eat.
As much as millennials, you know, we love these 90s movies, so I think it's very hard for millennials to sit through something that was made before 2000 at this point.
You think?
Our attention span can't handle anything that's not, you know, shorter cuts. And older movies weren't like that.
I know.
I'm good for about 90 minutes now, and I am I'm a movie man.
I was really trying to do lots of cuts in these videos, but then I thought, I think part of the charm with this is that you just keep it running, right? That's my opinion.
Improvisational.
Right. It's one cut. One take. Okay, folks. Last 2 pancakes going in. I hate to just throw away this batter, but I'm also hungry and want this to be over. How's your eye?
Well, until you brought it up.
I can save some batter for the top. For my topping. Now, you don't have to do that. And folks,
I
should make a disclaimer there. You probably shouldn't do that. Do as I say, not as I do, because...
You sound like a parent now.
Some people probably shouldn't do it.
Are either of us even on camera at the moment?
No.
I think basically just
the food, but that's fine.
I just realized that.
It's kind of cold in here.
Yeah, a little bit.
I think the high today was 17, which for Tennessee, pretty darn low. Oh, I know what
we can do. Moving up to show your face.
I know what we can do. Let's get... I don't know if I can repeat that or not. Excuse me. Excuse me again.
There we go.
Nothing says breakfast like a mug with your grandmother's glamour shot on it. Can you see that? And the back says rise and shine.
Too much.
My cousin made this for me. It was a joke.
I just helped out the viewers by moving it up just a little bit to show your face.
Now, can you do me a favor?
Sure.
Circle around here. And heat us up some syrup. I would like sugar-free. What are you going to have? You don't have to. You can have whatever.
I'm going to do light.
Okay. Then choose which one is yours and heat it up in the microwave here.
Taking a quick quarter cup. I'm measuring it out. This is what I'm like when I do the Weight Watchers. Because you can eat whatever you want as long as it's portioned. Portions has always been a problem of mine.
A slice of pizza the size of this frying pan is only 5 points.
Not true, Diane.
If that spills.
I mean, it is true. There. Tyler has this idea in his head that I'm a toddler in the kitchen or in life. Mentally.
I think it's gone. How are you going to track these pancakes, though? See, that's where I get confused.
I'll just write pancakes.
Yeah, but one's going to be huge and the other two are smaller.
Yeah, but to me, the huge one
is two.
So technically, I'm having four pancakes.
What, the sugar-free?
Do you want to measure?
No. That's good.
The freedom in just squeezing it out like that.
Okay, now I'm going to take our bacon, and it's cooled down, so I'm going to set it to the side. I'm going to take the hot pancakes that have been warming in here. That way you're not just stuck with a bunch of cold pancakes. Set it over here. Oh my gosh, they smoke it. Mm. Maybe about a minute for the syrups or so. And then, I don't know about y'all. Butter, 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 real, real, real butter. Okay, folks. We are going to plate these up, and we'll come back right before we do a taste test.
What's tracking?
Ladies and gentlemen, tracking is key.
Okay, folks, there they are. Now, stay tuned for the next video if you want to see us eat them. And I mean, please.
Oh, we're doing two?
Yeah. Bye.